breakfast at our hotel. It's really nice. And there's a tablecloth and everything. And also the food is pretty good too. We are going to, like, some say the most beautiful church in the world. I don't know what this is, but it looks like it's part of the big church thing. So it's so big it doesn't even fit in the camera. Even though I'm zoomed all the way out. Giant dome. If you look closely, you can already see that there's some people up there. So I think we have tickets to go up there. I think there are 400 some steps this time only. Enter the church. It is super duper duper big. The dome is over there. You can get a little preview sneak peek. Now we can see the dome and the beautiful view. Oh my god, it's so beautiful.
And sweaty host.
After climbing more than 400 steps of stairs.
Yes.
So he used a technique called fresco seco, which in English means dried fresco. And this is when, instead of mixing paint in with wet plaster, you just paint directly onto dried plaster. So the paint dries as a thin layer on top, like it does on a normal painting.
This is, we found out, we thought it was a crypt, even though we at the front desk, the security thought it was a crypt. This is actually the old church. And then because they were making the big new church, they had to knock this one down. So this is what church is like 1,000 years ago. They destroyed it though. And then like only 50 years ago, they just rediscovered it and started excavating. And they found all these ancient artifacts. Right, Aiden?
Very cool.
Wait. brightness up. Cool.
Yeah.
In a museum. There was no line in the museum, and we had a ticket already, so that was pretty good. So it looks pretty cool. Probably won't stay in this museum for long. We have places to be. Like there's two giant gold doors that are super detailed with different pictures on every single little tile. That's really cool. Really scary statue. Very scary woman. Scary. And then there are a bunch of various body parts of people, which is nice, I guess. It's a bunch of marble sculptures. There is a picture of Dante
holding the book called The Divine Comedy.
Yes, that's correct. What are the three stages after death?
Inferno, something else.
Purgatory.
Purgatory, and something else.
Heaven.
It's not called heaven, though. It's called something else.
I'm pretty sure it's called heaven.
No, it's not.
That's a big, big dome. And then inside the dome, there's also like a little model drawing. Very detailed.
Very cool.
Micro mosaics.
Oh, wow. Little tiny mosaics.
I wonder if I zoom in, you can see.
Oh, I moved it down.
Yeah, see the little tiny details of mosaic. That's what it is.
Okay.
This three giant books of music. Paintings on them too. Pretty cool. Music notes. These are like old fashioned music notes. I don't know how to read these. I don't know how to read that. We are in another mini church, it looks like. And on the roof this time, it's not a fresco, but it's golden Byzantine style mosaics. So awesome. And then how the structure of this building. Different church. This one is like a Church of the Cross, something like that. Basically, looks like two people against each other. That's what it looks like from here. Stained glass. everywhere. Apparently Michelangelo and Galileo resting here because they're dead. And then they're giant. We're walking down a set of stairs in the church basilica, and then we thought it was gonna lead us to like a crypt, but led us to this pretty little courtyard. So it's pretty cool. This is the tomb of Michelangelo, famous sculptor and artist. If you look at this door, it says that Michelangelo was supposed to be buried in Rome, but then people smoked, Florentine smoked his body back home. Is the tomb of Dante. He's a famous writer, probably best known for writing the Divine Comedy, which had his thoughts on what life was after death. Super cool.
You can see right now the church bells are ringing.